the main finding in this paper is that there is a smart spinal circuit that is working to control the position of your hand in external space. And this is an important finding because previously people would have thought that this kind of function would be something that was done in the cerebral cortex. And what we're showing is that it's already being done at the level of the spinal cord.
What we were looking for originally in this paper is to see where in the nervous system information from multiple joints are combined to help you control the hand in external space. And the joints that we were particularly interested in were the wrist and the elbow.
So right now you're too extended, so now you're a little more flexible, turn to me.
What a person's doing underneath this screen is they're holding on to a robot manipulandum, and this robot has the capability of flexing or extending your elbow and your wrist at the same time. So what the person and what the subjects in our experiments are having done to them is their elbow is being flexed always, but then their wrist might be flexed or the wrist might be extended, and the combination of these joint perturbations dictate where your hand ends up in space. Now what we see is that these spinal circuits don't really care about what's happening at the individual joints. They care about where the hand is in the external world and generates a response that tries to put the hand back to where it came from. So what we can do with this type of experimental design is measure the latencies or the timing in which these muscle responses are evoked after we stretch a muscle. And what we found in our work is that these evoked responses happen so quickly that the only place that they could be derived from or generated from is from the spinal circuits themselves.
Well, I think from a conceptual level, there's been a recent trend in this field to really focus on the cortical contributions to this kind of hand control. And by now showing that at least one important function is done at the level of the spinal cord, it opens up a whole new areas of investigation, is saying what else is done at the spinal level? What else have we potentially missed in this domain?